What up, everyone? I've got a real business story with Nomadic Matt about how he's grown a seven-figure blog talking about how to be a cheap-ass traveler. This is a friend I've known for quite a while, and I'm excited to share his story because he was working in a hospital being an administrator, probably like you. It's like when I was at Intel. And so he shares exactly with me in this video about, one, how did he get his blog started? Two, how did he grow it to 15 million people a month? And three, how does he exactly make money? There was actually a lot of things I was surprised to learn. Excited for you to hear today. Enjoy.
What was your story? What was your beginning?
I worked in healthcare for 3 years after college. I was an admin to the vice chair of surgery.
It sounds boring. Is it as boring as it sounds?
It's boring as hell. There were about four people in the office. Everyone's just admin, and I spent pretty much all day staring in front of a computer. In 2005, I took a trip to Thailand. I met a bunch of backpackers, and I really loved what they were doing because the previous year I had gone to Costa Rica, and I fell in love with travel. I was like, this is amazing. It's not boring. I'm doing interesting things every day. I'm meeting people from around the world. It's super exciting. So like, you got the travel bug. And I was like, that's what I want to do. Screw my job. So I thought, you know what? I'm not going to do this hospital thing anymore. I'll finish my MBA. I'll go travel for a year, get out of my system, backpack, have cool stories, and then get like a boring corporate job for the rest of my life. So in 2006, I left after finishing the MBA. So I made the money last for 18 months because I ended up working in Thailand as an English teacher. And so I came home, I had no money and I needed a job. So my cousin had a staffing firm. So she placed me at a hospital.
Back at a hospital.
Oh, because a doctor's assistant was going on maternity leave and they needed someone to fill in. I used that time to start my blog. What can I do that would allow me to keep traveling? I need money. And I thought, travel writer seems really cool. So I started my blog as a way to have just like an online resume. A couple of articles, here's where I've been published, hiring me to do writing.
When was the first time you started getting paid for not doing the hospital stuff?
I started making money on the blog at the end of 2008. So back in those days, you could sell text link ads on your website. So I originally, like, this was a side hustle. I went back to Asia, I started teaching again, and in my spare time worked on the blog. And one day someone was like, hey, we'll pay you $1,000 to put these five links on your website. And I thought, wow, $1,000. I just kept on doing that. Like, I would go like, Noah, like, hey, I see all these links on your website. I'll share contacts. Like, can you give me your contacts? I'll give you my contacts. One of the biggest things that helped during this time was I got really into spammy AdSense sites. Everything was just like, get the person to click on the Google ads.
Yeah.
Right? So I used to build one, how to like train your beagles, like how to raise puppies. Like, I actually had one on how to grow corn. What I learned from that was how Google worked, how SEO worked, like marketing, which I used to then put back into my actual thing I cared about, Nomadic Matt. Like, the guys that were teaching, I remember one day the guy was like, Matt, why are you wasting all your time trying to build these stupid websites? You're a travel expert. Focus on your main, like, focus on the website. And I was like, that's really good. So I ended up selling all these websites.
Like, how'd you take that from there to like the million people you get them every month visiting your site?
One, I had the advantage of starting early, but I went and learned marketing when all the other travel bloggers were not. So a couple of like things that plays into later is, one, I started following journalists, and my first big hit was when the Frugal Traveler from the New York Times was like, any of these travel bloggers make money? And I was like, I do. I ended up getting on the New York Times and they did a whole profile on me. I was still on a shared server back then and it just crashed my website.
Nice. Like,
so that was probably early 2010. And then in 2011, I met Ramit Sethi. He got me a guest post on his website. And then I realized sort of the power of guest posting. And I started doing a lot more guest posting in 2011, 2012. 2013, the book came out, like How to Travel the World on $50 a Day. And that was a major point because I started to get tons of press and I was like legitimate in the eyes of the world. I wasn't some blogger. I was a travel writer with a book.
How long did it take you to quit your job?
So I stopped teaching English in the middle of 2009. By then, I was making enough money from text links, these side websites, and I actually wrote a book called How to Make Money with Your Travel Blog, and that was enough to allow me to like quit my teaching job. Not a ton of money, but it was enough to keep traveling on the road, like pretty much indefinitely. I would say one of the biggest things is getting outside of travel, right? I go to a travel conference, we're all talking about travel, right? I get on your travel website, you get on my travel website, we're just basically speaking to the noise.
You're sharing the same audience as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, you know. So leaving that space and going to tech conferences and like FinCon and going to like mastermind things and podcaster things and being everybody else's travel guy. There is not an interview I will not do. If you send me questions, I will send it back.
So are these, it was a bunch of things that have combined. It's not like one major thing that's helped you get to the million. It's like you've done this one now. It's almost 10 years.
Yeah, not yet. I didn't really consider it a business until probably after that New York Times hit. So it's not like this one thing made my whole business. It's one thing gets me going, and then like you get another thing that gets it going, and it's really steps.
And so what separates someone who's been able to make it like you versus the other people that want to have these travel writing businesses?
Two things. First, I don't do it for myself. I teach people, other people, how to travel the world on a budget. What I do isn't about the service of myself. I could go get $1 million in brand partnerships, right? But I always think about, how does this help somebody else travel? Not, how does this help me travel? So the other big thing is really, there's a long game, right? The people who are like, I wanna get paid to travel, when they realize like, oh wow, this is gonna take a lot of work, they quit. The people who really care and are passionate about it, they stay.
For the monetization, so how did you change? Because I know you're not selling text links anymore.
I do affiliates and I have my own guidebooks. So I have 8 destination specific guides.
Okay.
And then 3 general guides on like teaching and solo travel and points and miles. Text links come, they go. Sponsored posts come, they go. Brand deals come and go. Like the hot thing now, influencer marketing. What happened if 3 years from now, that's not the hot thing?
What's the percentage of revenue that comes from your affiliate stuff, which is like credit cards and like flights? What are the affiliate stuff? It's like credit cards?
So like flight bookings, hotel bookings, tours, travel insurance, okay. All that sort of things you need for a trip.
And out of your revenue, what's the breakout of affiliate versus what you've created?
I would say it's probably about 15% ebooks, 40% affiliates, and then what's the remainder there, 35%. From my travel media school, which teaches people blogging, photography, and writing.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I didn't know
that. Yeah, we're gonna have a conference next year too. So like sort of trying to get people to build better travel businesses.
What's the most exciting thing going on right now? What are you most looking forward to with your business?
Business-wise, I'm looking forward to like finally developing a team. My assistant is finally becoming my product manager conversion person. I've hired a part-time designer so we can move things along quicker. We got a research assistant now. So like really just developing the team so we can make content and content updates a lot quicker. You know, travel is always changing, prices are in flux. So I don't like having outdated content on my website. I'm just really excited to like finally build a proper company.
So that Nomadic Matt story was awesome. Here are some key takeaways for you. First, Matt didn't quit his job. He didn't go get a loan. He didn't go jump off a cliff. He just started doing a side hustle while he was working at the hospital. So don't worry about going full out on it. Just get something started today. Secondly, Matt carved out his angle. Instead of being another travel blogger, Matt became known as a travel dude on the cheap. And he posted about that really aggressively. As well, he went and expanded his audience by going on Tim Ferriss and going to like FinCon, a financial blogging conference, connecting with new audiences to show them traveling. And number 3, Matt adjusted his business over time. You guys gotta be aware of this. You can't keep doing the same thing over and over. Now what he does is he sells books, he does tours, he has affiliates, and he's evolved that business. So don't worry about what you're doing today. Just start it and realize that your business will evolve and adapt over time. Make sure to leave a comment who you want me to do below, hit that subscribe button or whatever the hell you guys wanna do. Really appreciate you guys watching. Enjoy.